What's going on, guys? So another busy day, so that means another morning walk. And like, for those of you that don't know, I have actually finished my Bachelor's of Business. So I've done business in uni, and I've also got my own like company and business, which is called JD Fitness, which like offers customized meal plans, nutritional coaching, stuff like that. So basically I'm like an online personal trainer, which is something like I don't really like to say, because nowadays everyone with a six pack is like an online coach, an online personal trainer and all that. So I sort of avoid that name. But in uni, like, they asked me, like one of my classmates asked me, he said, like, now that you've got your own company in fitness, like, do you regret doing a business course rather than like pursuing something in the like the fitness industry? And I thought about it for a while and thought, no, I don't. Because without like the business course, I wouldn't have the mindset to turn fitness into like a business, or like turn what I'm passionate about into like a business with like a proper income and stuff like that. To be honest, I wouldn't even have the confidence to do that, because I wouldn't know like how to start, where to start, what stuff I need to like think of and put in place, like what process do we need to put in place to make it like a profitable business. So that is why business and fitness, like, for me, have got like hand in hand, really. Also, fitness has taught me that like it doesn't happen overnight. Like, you can't create like a successful business overnight. And same goes for like for fitness. Like, you can't get a six pack overnight, or you can't lose weight overnight, or build muscle overnight. It doesn't happen overnight. It takes time. And I think fitness has taught me that like I need to work hard and be patient and just enjoy the process, basically, and that applies for business as well. So fitness has taught me to like think more like long term, and that has also like that has given me like the patience in business as well, to not like constantly think short term, like, I need the money now, but like to think long term. And like with fitness, I think long term, like I think, okay, I try to gain like a half a kilo a week instead of just trying to gain as much weight as possible as quickly as possible. And with business, I think long term, as in like I try and provide as much value first. Like, if I just provide as much value and try and help as many people as possible, then the money will come, you know what I mean? And I think in both fitness and business, you just need like a strong mind, and I think fitness has really helped me with that. Like, put myself through like vigorous tasks in fitness, like trying to like bench press and do all kinds of mad workouts. That has taught me to have like a strong mind in business, and also like in uni, like studying and all that. Like, when people are really stressed out because of a test, I was like, hang on, you know, we've got this, we're just gonna put in the work and we're gonna do it. And that, like, fitness has taught me that. So like, long-term thinking, strong mind, and also like knowing that it doesn't happen overnight, though, those are, I'll go this way, those are the most important things that fitness has taught me, and has also applied to like my business. Also, I think nutrition has played like a really big role in both of them. Like, you need to fuel your body properly for both aspects, both fitness and business. Like, you can't expect yourself to do 18 hours of solid work if you're on like crisp and chips and, I don't know, like bottles of Coke and stuff like that. You can't do it. Like, maybe when you're 14, 13, but when you're my age, well, that sounds really old, but when you're getting to like 23, 24, you need to start thinking about nutrition. I need to start like eating healthier to like perform at your best, basically. Same goes for fitness, obviously. Like, if you're trying to gain muscle, like, you can't be eating shite. You need to be eating properly, thinking about your nutrition. So to rein it all back in, I go back to the question, do I regret doing a business course rather than pursuing something in fitness? Hell no, because I think they've gone so hand in hand, and without the one I wouldn't have the other, basically. And in terms of like content, because obviously I'm doing quite a lot of like business type content creation type of content nowadays, I will still be doing fitness content, because fitness plays such a big role in my life, like in terms of mindset, in terms of working hard, and also just I think that I need a strong body to have a strong mind as well. So fitness content will definitely be on the channel always and forever. This is always a channel about becoming the strongest version of ourselves, and that is mentally as well as physically. Anyway, guys, I'm nearly there, so I need to wrap up this video. Like this video if you got something out of it. Comment down below what you think in terms of business and fitness. Do they go together, or are they two completely separate things? Am I just chatting shite? Subscribe to the channel for more, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Gotta do what I gotta do.